Falmouth, Maine. In 1658, Falmouth was over 100 square miles of rural areas and coastline. In 1765, Cape Elizabeth and South Portland broke away, with Portland and Westbrook following in 1785 and 1814, respectively leaving Falmouth the size it is today, 32 square miles and home to more than 11,000 people. At the Winroad Fire Station, every year the garage is transformed into a noisy but fun Halloween party. The Boy Scouts hold their annual pancake breakfast, and the fire station houses 4 fire trucks and 4 ambulances. Buckner Road Fire Station houses 4 fire trucks and 2 ambulances. They respond to over 1,500 medical and fire-related calls each year. The Falmouth Police Station makes up several divisions, which include the Marine Unit, the K-9 Unit, Criminal Investigation, Emergency Management, and Patrol. The Falmouth School District's DARE program is promoted by Officer Susie. St. Mary's Episcopal Church on Route 88 was built in 1890 as a family chapel. In 1754, the Falmouth Congregational Church was built. It is located on Falmouth Road next to the town hall. It serves the community by hosting Boy Scout meetings, Christmas fairs, bean suppers, and Sunday worship at 10 a.m. In 1930, Holy Martyrs Catholic Church was located on Route 88. It began as a small wooden church. It is now a large brick church where over 750 families worship. Pine Grove Cemetery, located on Route 88, is in the place where Fort Newcastle once stood from 1701 to 1715. This is where the British and the French fought for whether America should be French or English. The memorial was erected in 1928. America, land that
I love.
Lent and Plummer Moats buildings were once the public school for Falmouth, educating students from grades K through 12. These buildings were abandoned in the fall of 2011. Falmouth School District educates over 2,150 students, kindergarten through 12th grade. Our school district celebrates the many athletic championships and jazz band state titles, Teacher of the Year recognitions, as well as being voted top city to live and learn by Forbes magazine in 2011.
A singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on and on.
Falmouth Memorial Library provides many services such as book clubs, weekly children's programs, public computer usage, and thousands of books available for checkout. Legion Fields is a hot spot for Little League baseball and softball. The community gathers here for opening day, visits the snack shack, and this is also the home to the Ralph D. Caldwell Memorial Veterans Post 164. Get yourself off the ground, I said, yeah. greatest shopping locations are where many people in our community gather to see one another. In 2001, 68 acres of trails were preserved called Penobscot Falls on Allen Ave with a popular spot for fishing striped bass. Blackstrap Trails, acquired in 1995 as a part of conservation efforts, is located in West Falmouth along Blackstrap Road. This preserve is home to 600 acres of hiking and biking trails with a wide variety of birds, reptiles, and various native plants and animals. Community Park is where kids play soccer and football in the fall and snowmobiling and Nordic skiing in the winter. The community also uses the park for cross-country racing and summer camps. It's all right. Main Audubon is a 65-acre sanctuary with more than 2 miles of trails along woods, meadows, ponds, and salt marshes. There's a discovery center, nature shop, and hosts summer programs for children and educational programs for the community. Mackworth Island is 100 acres of heavily wooded hiking trails and the home of the Baxter School for the Deaf. It's all right. Town Landing is a place where people launch their boats. All sorts of people come here to buy freshly caught lobster and fish, sell their daily catch, or just enjoy the beautiful view. The Falmouth Town Hall, built in 1899, has seen many renovations. This is where town government meets and day-to-day operations of the town are served.